NBA Commissioner Adam Silver is set on changing the playoffs, and people love it. Why the NBA could and should look like the World Cup. TV people love it.
Does it feel shticky? Shticky in 2020 works. Shticky is an event. This would be an event. It would be a World Cup style event.
And I love the thought, but you can't just change the playoff format now. It feels like the NBA is using the pandemic as an excuse to mess with the playoffs. We all know Adam Silver has wanted to experiment with changes for a while. His ideas were squashed. Why did this get brought back up again? In this video, we'll break down the ideas they have to change the playoffs and why it's the wrong move at the wrong time. Hey, it's Casey, host of the AM Hoops YouTube channel, aka Walmart Steve Nash, according to Jacob. Hit subscribe and hit notification bells. It helps out the channel. We're still making 5 videos per week. Also, check out the AM Hoops podcast. Always drop in a fresh pod every Friday morning. Reports said in November, the NBA commissioner wanted to make big changes. Reseeding conference finals, having an in-season tournament, a play-in tournament to the playoffs. These are all ideas he got from soccer. In Paris this year with Michael Jordan and the Bucks owner, the commissioner admitted, quote, "I am jealous in certain ways of soccer globally." Team owners weren't ready to make those changes, so they tabled the discussions for later. And now for some random reason, Adam Silver is trying again. He asked NBA GMs recently about a few ideas. One idea, reseeding the playoffs 1 through 16. So the bracket would look like this. No conferences. The Bucks would still play the Magic, but the Lakers would play the Nets instead of Memphis. I don't need to read them all, you can see them here. Another option is to do group play, like the World Cup or the Champions League. The top 20 teams by record are all involved. They don't include the bottom 5 in each conference, they're out. Mostly teams with a mathematical chance of getting in anyway. If you're not familiar, here's how group play works. 5 groups of 4 teams. All seeded to keep competitive balance. The top tier, the Bucks, Lakers, Raptors, Clippers, those are 1 seeds and they all get their own group. Then you randomly pair the 1 seeds with 1 other team from each tier. And I'll admit, this is great television. They do it in soccer and it is fun as hell to see what group your team gets into. There's always the group of death. In the NBA, you could have 1 group with the Bucks, Celtics, and Rockets. They play round robin style and the top 2 teams go onto a traditional bracket. Here's what the group stage would look like after a random draw. Just one example. I think the group of death here is group 2. The Lakers in a group with the Heat, Rockets, and Pelicans and only 2 teams advance. Now for 10 years, rumors of changes like these have been out there, but things like travel wouldn't allow for it and they say this is the perfect setup. And I get it, everyone's at Disney World, no travel, people are craving the NBA, they always complain about the East being worse than the West. So get rid of conferences and give fans what they want. It seems like the perfect time. Except this is actually the worst possible time. I mean, if you want to make big changes like this, you do it before the season and everyone can agree and then they plan accordingly. Instead, like a team like the Bucks who have the best overall record, they worked all year and normally they would have to just beat 1 dominant West team in the finals, you know, like every other champion ever who's come out of the East. Now all of a sudden, if you just flip it on them, in their bracket, 1 through 16, the Bucks would have to beat the Clippers and the Lakers to win a title. What is that? I'm sure the Lakers would love this. The Clippers are out of their side of the bracket unless they reseed. Then they'd only have to beat the Bucks or the Clippers to win a title, not both. The seeds themselves are BS at this point. The Pacers are 11, the Mavericks are 13. What if Luka's team got an Eastern Conference regular season? Look, I am actually in favor of changes like this. I am a soccer fan. I don't want conferences anymore, but this is the kind of change you make before the season, not in the middle of it for no apparent reason. There are legacies on the line here, like LeBron trying to win a 4th ring, Kawhi trying to be the first to win finals MVP with 3 teams, Giannis to win his first championship. There are free agent implications. Rumors say how Milwaukee plays in these playoffs have a lot to do with if Giannis stays. This random change could affect that franchise forever. Even for the team who wins, there's a lot of talk about an asterisk title, right? And I've been vocal on this channel that there should not be an asterisk. Whoever wins won a hell of a season, literally, 2020 will go down as historic for all the wrong reasons. And every team will compete under the same conditions. What asterisk? But it will be an asterisk if they randomly tinker with the format and make it look like no playoffs have looked before. I could easily see history saying, oh yeah, they won the 2020 title, but that was the year they did weird World Cup things for some reason. In the group stage idea, two losses could mean you're out. I mean, what if the Lakers or the Bucks had two bad games? Not impossible. Those teams get knocked out on a fluke and we're supposed to take the champion seriously? No. I can't figure out what the reason for these changes are. Like, why are you changing this right now? To create extra buzz for the playoffs? They're called the NBA playoffs. There's already a ton of buzz. I mean, a few days ago, we just had an exhibition golf match with two old golfers and two old quarterbacks in the rain, and 6 million people watched. You don't need extra buzz. So what do I think they should do? All right, well, it's a crazy idea, so get ready to take notes. So you take the top eight in each conference and play a tournament. Best of seven, the East champ plays the West champ for the final. Yeah, it's just the normal NBA playoffs. Sorry, I know that's boring. And of course, there's the people saying, hey, we didn't get a chance to finish the regular season. What about the teams who could have snuck in? Look, really? It's just the Pelicans and the Blazers. In the East, for example, the Wizards are 5 games behind the Magic for 8. They weren't gonna get in. In the West, the Pels and Portland are 3.5 games back of Memphis, but they had their chance. I feel like all year we were waiting for the Blazers or the Spurs to make a run. We were waiting all year for Zion to get healthy. Yeah, the Kings are scrappy, but none of it ever clicked. Memphis was supposed to drop out of 8th with a tough schedule. Instead, they went out and beat the Nuggets and the Blazers and the Mavs and the Lakers. These teams played 60 plus games. That is enough. This is not unprecedented. In 1999, there was a strike. 50 games that season. 2011 strike, 66 games that season. But if the NBA decides to randomly change the playoff format, and like, let's just say it only happens for 2020, it almost forces history to put an asterisk. The only way around that is if they kept the changes forever. Really, this just feels like an excuse to get Zion Williamson and Damian Lillard into the playoffs. And that is total BS to the teams that earned it. A play-in tournament brings more teams and people to Disney World. The more people, the less safe. And the NBA cannot afford to have the playoffs shut down. I know they've lost a lot of money, but it would be a waste of time, money, and health if this goes south. So you just get the 16 teams that are in playoff position play a traditional NBA playoffs at Disney World. And if you want to make these changes, talk about it for next year. They need to keep as much normalcy as possible in this abnormal time. Keep it safe. Do not disrespect what the best teams did in the regular season to earn their place. And do not force history to put an asterisk next to the champion's banner. To me, the good news is these changes probably aren't going to happen. Team owners would have to vote on it, and assuming every Western Conference team votes to change, you still need 5 Eastern Conference team owners to agree. That's not going to happen. East teams have benefited for years of being in a weaker conference. The only reason I'm a little nervous, though, is if Adam Silver makes his pitch based on money. If there is some way to show that these changes would bring a lot of cash, maybe he does get those 5 votes. The NBA could lose as much as $2 billion because of this shutdown. Some team owners own businesses that are in trouble. The Pacers' Herb Simon, a shopping mall tycoon, he's not exactly Steve Ballmer. Ultimately, if it does come down to money, it's greedy. I know the NBA could lose as much as $2 billion. That's meaningful to the players and to the owners. But you have a chance to salvage the season and crown a champion during a pandemic. Don't try to force all 30 teams into Disney World like some of these changes I've seen out there. I think even 20 teams is too much. You've got 16 teams that have earned their place. They should be in the playoffs. In the end, I hope people see all the reasons not to make drastic changes for no good reason and keep things status quo for now. Look, I'm not saying we should keep tradition because that's the way we've always done it. I mean, that's not how I think. And when I originally heard these ideas back in November, I was a fan. I was like, cool, let's do that. But not just right before the playoffs. Like, what's the reason? A pandemic? So now that's just an excuse to change everything around? I think they're really good ideas. They are. I'm a fan. but they come at a really, really bad time. Support AM Hoops and click subscribe. Don't miss a daily NBA video.